Hello everyone, in this video, we will learn about the congruences and modular arithmetic. Alright, first, we're going to talk about the definition of congruence. Let A and B be integers, and M be a natural number. We say that A is congruent to B modulo M if A and B have the same remainder. When divided by M, we say A congruent to B mod M. In other words, M divide A minus B, or A minus B divisible by M. Alright, so let's take a look at the example right here. 6 congruent to 12 mod 3, which means 6 minus 12 divisible by 3, right? Because 6 minus 12 is going to be negative 6 divisible by 3. Or we can say 3 divide 6 minus 12. Alright. Next one, negative 5 congruent to 3 mod 2, which means negative 5 minus 3 divisible by 2, right? Because negative 5 minus 3 is going to be negative 8 divisible by 2. Or we can say 2 divide negative 5 minus 3. Alright, next one, similar, 29 congruent to 129 mod 100, and the last one, 53 congruent to 1 mod 13. Alright, we're gonna do the same manner right here. Okay, now if A, B, and K are integers and M is a natural number, the following always holds. First, A congruent to B mod M. Next, A congruent to B mod M if and only if A minus B equals M times K. In other words, A minus B divisible by M. Now, I'm going to add B both sides, so it turns out to be A equals B plus M times K. Alright, we have 9 properties right here. Let A, B, C, D, E be integers, and M and B a natural number. Then, reflexive property says A congruent to A mod M. Next, symmetric property, A congruent to B mod M. Then, B congruent to A mod M. Transitive property, A congruent to B mod M. B congruent to C mod M, then A congruent to C mod M. Addition, subtraction, and multiplication property. If we have A congruent to B mod M and C congruent to D mod M, now if we add them up vertically, we have the first one right here. If we subtract them vertically, we get the second one right here. If we multiply them vertically, we get the third one right here. Alright. If we add the first one both sides by E, we get this one. If we multiply the first one both sides by E, we get this one. Alright, let's move on to the exponent rule. If we have A congruent to B mod M, then we're going to raise to the n both sides. We have A to the n congruent to B to the n mod M. Next, we have modulus multiplication. What does it mean? It means A congruent to B mod M. Then we're going to multiply every single term right here by N. We get this guy. Next, division. If A congruent to B mod M, then A divided by E congruent to B divided by E mod M. For E to be a common factor of A and B. And E and M should be co-prime numbers. Next one, A congruent to B mod M. A congruent to B mod M prime. Then A congruent to B mod M and M prime. Scaling, A times C congruent to B times C mod M. Where C and M are co-prime numbers, then A congruent to B mod M. Alright. We have the Fermat's Little Theorem. Let A be an integer and P be a prime number, then A to the P congruent to A mod P. in special case, we have if A and B are coprime numbers, then A to the P minus 1 congruent to 1 mod P. Alright, now let's take a look at the first type of this lesson. We need to find the remainder of the division. So we have 6 divisions right here. Okay, now let's take a look at the question A. 92 to the 94 divided by 15. Now, what is the remainder? So we're going to start with 92. We know that 92 congruent to 2 mod 15. Why? Because we have 92 minus 2 divisible by 15, right? Because 92 minus 2 is going to be 90, right? 90 divided by 15 is going to be 6, right? So by the definition right here, right? Now, we need 94 as a power. So we're going to raise to the power of 94 cosine. So we have 94 right here. Now, we're going to use the transitive property right here. Alright, so we're going to deal with 2 to the 94. So we have 2 to the 4 always congruent to 1 mod 15, right? Because 2 to the 4 is going to be 16. 16 minus 1 is going to be 15. 15 divisible by 15, alright? So, but we need 2 to the 94, right? So we're going to raise to the 23 cosine. So we have 2 to the 92 congruent to 1 mod 15, right? Now we're going to apply the formula right here, the multiplication property right here. We're going to apply this guy. Alright, so we're going to multiply both sides by 4, right? 4, which means 2 power of 2. So it can be 2 power of 94 congruent to 4 mod 15, right? Alright, now by transitive property, I call this is 1. I call this is 2, alright? We have this one and this one as a middleman. So we're going to use the transitive property. So we have 92 to the 94 congruent to 4 module 15. Alright, so in other words, the remainder for this division should be 4. Alright, let's move on to question B right here. We're going to start with 1944 congruent to negative 2 mod 7. Alright, because 1944 minus negative 2 is going to be 1946 divisible by 7. Now we need 1944 to the 2005. So we're going to raise to the 2005 both sides. So we have 2005 right here. And this one should be 2005, right? Alright, so next one, we're going to start with negative 2 to the power of 3. Always congruent to negative 1 mod 7, right? Now we're going to raise to the 668 both sides. So we have this guy to the 668. This guy to the 668. So we have negative 2 to the 2005 4. Congruent to 1. Modulo 7. Now we need negative 2 to the 20 over 5. So we're going to multiply negative 2 both sides. So negative 2 right here. And then this guy turns out to be 1 times negative 2. It's going to be negative 2 right here. Alright, so this guy turns out to be negative 2 to the 20 over 5. Congruent to negative 2 mod 7. Alright, I'm going to call this a 1. I call this a 2. So by transitive property, I have 1944 to the 20 over 5. Congruent to negative 2 mod 7. In other words, the remainder should be negative 2. Next one, we're going to move on to question C. So we're going to start with 1532. So 1532 congruent to 2 mod 9, right? Because 1532 subtract 2 divisible by 9, right? So now we need the power of 5. So we're going to raise to the power of 5 both sides, right? So this is 5, this is 5, right? By this property, exponential rule right here, okay? Now, so we're going to use transitive property. So we're going to start with 2 to the 5th right here. So we have 2 to the 5th congruent to 5 mod 9, right? Because 2 to the 5th is going to be 32. 32 subtract 5 is going to be 27. 27 divisible by 9, right? So by transitive property right here, so we have 1532 to the 5th congruent to 5 mod 9. Alright, now we're going to subtract 1 both sides, right? Because we need this one right here. We're going to apply the subtraction property. So we subtract 1 both sides right here. Subtract 1, subtract 1. So we have 1532 to the 5th minus 1 congruent to 4 mod 9, right? So the remainder should be 4. So the answer is 4 right here. Now let's move on to question D right here. So we need to find the remainder of 3 to the 20 over 3. Divide by 13. Alright, so what should we do? So observe that 20 over 3 equals 3 times 6 over 7 plus 2. Right, so we leave it over there. Now we have 3 to the third congruent to 1. Mod 13. Because 3 to the third is going to be 27. 27 subtract 1 is going to be 26. 26 divisible by 13. If we raise to the 6 over 7 both sides. So what do we have? So does that mean we have 3 to the third times 6 over 7. Congruent to 1 mod 13, right? Now we're going to multiply 3 square both sides. So it could be 3 to the 3 times 6 over 7 times 3 square equals 1 times 3 square is going to be 9 mod 13. Alright, so this one turns out to be 3 to the 3 times 6 over 7 plus 2 congruent to 9 mod 13. Alright, now this guy actually 3 to the 20 over 3 congruent to 9 mod 13. So 3 to the 20 over 3 divided by 13, the remainder is 9. Now let's move on to question E. Alright, so we have 5 square congruent to 1 module 12, right? Because 5 square equals 25. 25 subtract 1 is going to be 24. 24 divisible by 12, alright? So now we need 5 to the 70. So we're going to write to the 35 both sides. So we have these guys write to the 35. This guy's right to the 35. So we have 5 to the 70 congruent to 1 module 12. Alright, similarly, we have 7 square congruent to 1 mod 12. Because 7 square equals 49. 49 subtract 1, 48. 48 divisible by 12. Alright. Next one, we need 7 to the 50, so we're going to raise to the 25 both sides. So we're going to end up with 7 to the 50 congruent to 1 mod 12. Alright, I call this a 1. I call this guy 2. Now I'm going to add 1 and 2 vertically using the property right here. Alright, so I have 5 to the 70 plus 7 to the 50 congruent to 1 plus 1 equals 2 mod 12. Alright, so the answers must be 2 right here. Alright, let's move on to the last question. Alright, so we're going to start with 3 to the 5th. It's going to be congruent to 1 mod 11. Right? Because 3 to the 5th is going to be 243. 243 subtract 1 is going to be 242. 242 divisible by 11 is going to be 22. Alright? We need the power of 20 over 5, right? So we need to write this one to the 401. So 401 right here. Alright, so it could be 3 to the 20 over 5 congruent to 1 mod 11. Alright, similarly, we have 4 to the 5th congruent to 1 mod 11. Because 4 to the 5th minus 1 divisible by 11. Alright, now we need to raise to the 401 both sides. So the left hand side turns out to be 4 to the 20/5. Congruent to 1 mod 11. Alright, so now we use the addition property right here. We're going to add this guy up, right? I call this 1, I call this one 2. So we're going to add this guy up. The remainder should be 2, right? So when this guy divided by this guy, the remainder is 2, right? Now we're going to move on to the next one right here. We start with 3 to the 3rd congruent to 1 module 13. Because 3 to the 3rd is going to be 27. 27 subtract 1, 26. 26 divisible by 13. Alright. Now we need the power of 20/5. So we need to raise this one to the 6, 8. So this guy turns out to be 3 to the 20/4. Congruent to 1 module 13. Alright, now we use the multiplication property. So we're going to multiply both sides by 3. So this guy turns out to be 3 to the 20.05. Congruent to 3 mod 13. Now next one, we have 4 to the third congruent to negative 1 mod 13. Alright, so we're gonna raise to the 6, 8 both sides. So this guy turns out to be 4 to the 20.04. Congruent to 1 mod 13. Alright. Now we need 4 to the 20.05. So we're going to multiply both sides by 4. So it turns out to be 4 to the 20.05. Congruent to 4 mod 13. Alright, I call this is 2. I call this is 1. I'm gonna add them up using the addition property right here. So this guy, add this guy. Congruent to this guy, add this guy. It's gonna be 7. Module 13. So it's gonna be 7 right here. Alright, I'm gonna leave the example number 2 as a practice. Thank you for watching. I hope you enjoyed the video. Remember that if you're failing to prepare, you're preparing to fail. We rise like tall buildings as the chemicals they take us higher. The night's young, it has just begun. She puts her hand